Hello friends, welcome to the lecture on reservoir planning. In today's lecture, we will discuss about reservoir life, how life of a reservoir is estimated and various terminologies associated with this like sedimentation, trap efficiency, etc. So let us start. We will start with the trap efficiency. It is the ability of a reservoir to trap and retain incoming sediment, which is known as trap efficiency, and it is usually expressed as a percent of sediment yield of the catchment retained in the reservoir. So the trap efficiency is the ability of the reservoir to retain the incoming sediment whenever the water flows through the river, and when the river meets the reservoir, then thereby whatever the sediments are carried out by the river are deposited somewhere in the reservoir. If reservoir allows the water to outflow immediately, then there will be less time for the sediment to settle. But if the sediments settling part gets ample of time, then there will be ample of sediments which are deposited in the reservoir. So it is the ability of the reservoir to retain the incoming sediments. That is what the trap efficiency is. Trap efficiency of a reservoir depends upon host of parameters, the important ones being sediment characteristics, detention storage time, nature of outlets, and the reservoir operation. So here one graphical representation is shown, that is the Bruhn's curve of trap efficiency of a reservoir, on in which you can see that the capacity inflow ratio, you can see over there on the x-axis, and sediment trapped in percentage, they are given on the y-axis. So there is a specific relation between the sediment trapped in the percentage and the capacity inflow ratio. It is the ratio which we have to determine to work out the useful life of a reservoir. So what is capacity inflow ratio? Capacity refers to the original capacity of the dam in million meter cube, and inflow means what? Whatever the amount of water yearly the river carries into the reservoir in million meter cube, that is what the inflow. So this capacity inflow ratio you must know to work out the life of the reservoir. By looking at this figure, one can conclude that for the trap efficiency, it is nearly 100%. When there is capacity inflow, it is greater than 0.7. If you look at this, for capacity to inflow ratio, if it is more than 0.7, then the trap efficiency, it is nearly equal to 100%. For the ranges smaller than 0.7, trap efficiency you can calculate by the formula. Trap efficiency, it is equal to K into ln into bracket C upon I, that is capacity inflow ratio plus M, where this eta suffix T, it is equal to trap efficiency in percentage, C upon I is the capacity inflow ratio, where C is the capacity of the reservoir at full reservoir level in million meter cube, and I is the annual inflow into reservoir in million meter cube. K and M are the coefficient depend upon this C upon I. So here a table it is given where the capacity inflow ratio it is given, and corresponding the values of K and M are given. So just go through the table, see the values. Now how to calculate the reservoir life? So first of all, knowing the inflow rate, calculate the capacity inflow ratio and obtain the trap efficiency from the curve. So first of all, you have to find out the inflow rate. Whatever the water it is coming to the reservoir, that rate must be known to you. So first of all, you have to estimate, you have to find out that inflow rate. Then initially the capacity of the dam, design capacity, when there is no silt deposition, there is nothing, no sedimentation it is there. So you will consider that full capacity, and for that full capacity and incoming flow, you will find out this ratio, capacity to inflow ratio, and whatever the ratio you are going to get, you will correlate that ratio with the curve which is seen earlier, and you will find out the trap efficiency for that particular capacity inflow ratio. Okay, then divide the total capacity into any suitable interval. If say suppose your dam it is having 10 million meter cube of capacity, so you have to divide that total capacity into number of suitable intervals. If I take interval of 2 million meter cube, then there will be 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2, likewise 5 intervals I am going to consider. So you have to divide the capacity of the dam into suitable interval, say 10%, assuming the 10% capacity has been reduced due to the sediment deposit. Find the trap efficiency for the reduced capacity, that is 90% of the original, and the inflow ratio. So here your inflow ratio, inflow will be same. What we are considering, we are dividing the capacity into suitable interval, and I am considering that 10% capacity has been reduced due to sediment deposit. Now how much remaining? It is 90%. If the dam it is say 100 million cubic meter, it has initial capacity, and if I took the interval of 10%, so only 90 million meter cube capacity I am going to consider. And for this capacity, now I will find out again capacity to inflow ratio, and again I have to find out the trap efficiency for this particular new ratio. So for this interval of 10% capacity, find out the average trap efficiency by taking the average of eta found in step 2 and 3. So for this particular capacity, I have got one value of trap efficiency, and I have got also one value initially when I have not considered any deposit. For the full capacity of the reservoir, I have got one trap efficiency, and when there is 10% deposition, I have got second trap efficiency. So I will make an average of these two trap efficiencies here. Now determine the sediment inflow rate by taking the water samples and drying the sediment. So at actual dam site, you have to take the water samples at various intervals, and you have to dry them, and you have to find out how much is the dry weight of the sediment. You have to work out various densities of the sediments, okay, by actually collecting these water samples. Then multiply the total annual sediment transported by the trap efficiency found in step 3. You have to first of all find out the annual sediment transported. If you know the volume of water you have collected and how much sediment you have got, thereby you can calculate how much, knowing the inflow, how much sediment can be transported annually, that you can estimate mathematically, that you have to do here. So you have to find out the total annual sediment transported, and you have to multiply that value with the trap efficiency. Then divide the volume interval by the sediment deposited to get the number of years to fill this volume interval of 10% capacity. Suppose you know that 10% capacity, say it is 10 million meter cube, and the sediment deposited per year, say it is 1 million meter cube. So how much years will be required to fill this particular 10% capacity? 10 million meter cube divided by 1 million meter cube, it will come out as 10 years. Means what? It will require 10 years for fulfilling, for deposition of sediments to complete this 10% capacity. Okay? Then repeat the procedure for further intervals of the capacity. Now you will take into consideration 20% of the capacity of the dam, then 30%, 40% likewise, and you will repeat the same procedure. You will find out the values of trap efficiencies. Again, you will estimate the various parameters as shown. Then the total life of reservoir will be equal to the total number of years required to fill each of the volume intervals. suppose initial 10% volume of you have considered it requires say 10 years. Again, you are considering 10 remaining 10%. It requires say 11 years. Again, 10%, 15 years. So likewise, up to full storage capacity, how many years will be required for the sediment to be deposited? You will just sum up that. So suppose it is coming as 80 years, 85 years. So that will be your useful life of the reservoir. Generally, in practice, the reservoir life, it is terminated if its capacity comes down to 20% of its original capacity. If initially the reservoir, it has 100% storage capacity and it falls down by 80% and comes to only 20%, then we can say that the useful life of the reservoir, it should be terminated at that instant. Okay. Now, the sedimentation is the important part by which we can estimate the life of the reservoir actually. So what is the reservoir sedimentation? It is a difficult problem for which an economical solution has not yet been discovered, except by providing a dead storage to accommodate the deposits during the life of the dam. Disintegration, erosion, transportation and sedimentation are the different stages leading to silting of the reservoir. So here a conceptual sketch of density current and sediment deposit in a reservoir is shown. This delta formation usually takes place at the opening of the mouth of the river. When river meets the reservoir, this delta formation takes place. These are the density currents, and here you can see that dead storage, muddy lake, it is there. So entire deposits are deposited like this. This is in the form of delta formation, and this is in the form of muddy lake dead storage. Now, what are the causes of sedimentation? There are a number of causes which are enlisted, like nature of soil in the catchment area, then topography of the catchment area, which includes slopes and all those things, cultivation, if more cultivation it is there, then there is less sedimentation. Vegetation cover, if it is more, then sedimentation will be less, as the erosion of soil will be less. Intensity of rainfall, if it is more, then it will cause more sedimentation, more erosion of the soil. For the sediment management, either we can allow maximum water to be released so that less sediment will retain in the reservoir. But practically, it is not possible all the time. So, alternative options are catchment vegetation, construction of coffer dams, a watertight enclosure pumped dry to permit construction work below the waterline, or low height barriers. It is called as a coffer dam. Then flushing and desilting of the sediment. After frequent intervals, you can desilt the dam. You can take out the deposits by mechanical means. Then low level outlets, sediment sluicing. You can take out the sediments from the low level outlets at the dam. So these are the practices to manage the sediment, which are shown in pictorial view. Just go through that. Vegetation. Wooden barriers sometimes are used to prevent the erosion and thereby sedimentation. Stepped watershed for sediment control. Flushing of the sediments from reservoir. Mechanical desilting from the reservoir. Sediment sluicing. So I hope you have got the idea of life of reservoir, sediment deposition and its management. So I hope you have understood the concepts. If you face any difficulty, you can ask me on my email address dnpaitankarce@sanjeevani.org.in. Thank you for listening. Happy learning.